Meanwhile, Chinese ambassador to the Philippines, Wang Xilian, claims Beijing never opposed to the delivery of humanitarian supplies to BRB Sierra Madre, but he insists China will not allow the delivery of large-scale construction materials to a union show. Wang, meanwhile, welcomes the appointment of former Foreign Affairs Secretary Teodoro Loxi Jr. as the country's special envoy to China. He now hopes Manila will go back to the negotiating table to solve maritime disputes with Beijing.
We hope that the Philippine side will work with the Chinese side in the same direction, so that to strengthen the dialogue and consultation over maritime disputes, to seek effective ways to manage the maritime situation as soon as possible. And by the way, we welcome the appointment of the former Secretary of Foreign Affairs, Teddy Lotin, you know, as the special envoy of the President to China.
Now, weeks after Chinese ships fired water cannons at the Philippine vessels, Manila's resupply mission to troops stationed at the BRP Sierra Madre was successfully completed. Now, the mission was carried out despite attempts by China to interfere. At least four Chinese Coast Guard vessels and up to three Chinese militia vessels were spotted around the Ayunian Shoal when Tuesday's resupply mission was conducted.
They were trying to block the movements of our supply ships and the Coast Guard vessels, but fortunately, we were able to skip that and our ships were able to successfully reach the BRP Sierra Madre and deliver their supplies. I think what we did shows the resolve of the Philippine government in exercising our jurisdiction and our sovereign rights over Ayunian Shoal.
A former official of the Duterte administration speaks up over a supposed deal to remove the country's lone Navy outpost at the Ayunian Shoal. Former Executive Secretary Salvador Medeldea says former President Rodrigo made no such commitment, even as he sought warmer ties with Beijing.
The former president would never do that, because he knows that is a symbol of our sovereignty. No, simbolo ng bayan natin sa area na yan. Never did he say na aalisin ko that, nor did he make any commitment to remove that. He will never do that.
Critics have accused Duterte of making the deal with China to withdraw the BRP Sierra Madre in the West Philippine Sea, the rusty ship that became another flashpoint in maritime tensions between Manila and Beijing. Other former presidents, including Joseph Estrada and House Deputy Speaker Gloria Macapagal-Arroyo, also denied making any agreements with China. The Philippines mourning the death of the true loss of a true champion of the overseas Filipino workers, Susan Dukes Ople. Willard Cheng looks back on how the pioneer secretary of the Migrant Workers Department answered the call of duty while facing battles out in the world.
Before becoming secretary of the Department of Migrant Workers, Susan Dukes Ople was a champion of the rights and welfare of overseas Filipino workers for almost two decades. As the founder of the Blas Ople Policy Center and Training Institute, a nonprofit organization that helps distressed OFWs and their families. Ople was the daughter of the late Senator Blas Ople, who served as Labor Secretary of former President Ferdinand Marcos Sr. Ople ran for Senator in 2016 but lost her bid. Despite her advocacy, it was not an easy decision for her to accept the offer of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. to join his cabinet as she fought breast cancer.
2 years ago, I had breast cancer, you know.
Yeah.
So, I told this to Attorney Vic, our president. So, but you know what weighed also in my mind was what Father Jerry Orbo said. He said, the rest of your life, the best of your life. So I think I'm at that point where I want to give, you know, the best in me for the sector that I have loved all these years.
Ople was mentioned by Marcos in his inaugural address, an indication of his trust and confidence.
I am confident because I have an OPLE in my cabinet.
Even without a budget, OPLE hit the ground running as she faced major challenges. From attending to negotiations on unpaid wages of thousands of displaced Filipino workers in Saudi Arabia, to personally ensuring the safety of Filipinos in conflict areas such as Sudan, attending to cases of abused workers in the Middle East, finding ways to ease the queuing time of OFWs in government offices, and lending her ears to concerns of migrant workers.
I've been telling people, please watch my back then and let me know. Mamaya, I'm losing my moral compass.
OPLE managed to attend the President's State of the Nation address in July before going on medical leave. The Department of Migrant Workers announced OPLE's passing Tuesday afternoon, saying she was surrounded by her family and loved ones. The department also asked for prayers for the late secretary and her family. President Marcos mourned the passing of OPLE as tributes poured in from other officials and legislators.
It's a big loss. She's ang galing-galing ni Secretary Toots. It's a very, very sad news. I have lost a friend. The Philippines has lost a friend. Secretary Toots is a special person, and with a deep compassion, really, for the people that she had to care for, namely the migrant workers. It is a great loss for all of us. It is a great loss to the Philippines for the service that we know she could still have rendered had she lived.
Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri says OPLE's passing leaves an irreplaceable void. He committed to continue the great gains she has made by protecting and uplifting migrant workers and laborers. House Speaker Martin Romualdez calls OPLE's dedication to migrant workers a deeply ingrained passion. He called her a voice for the voiceless and a beacon of hope to many. Several other lawmakers expressed their condolences to OPLE's family. They remembered the late secretary as a dedicated public servant who cared deeply for the sector she served. OPLE called her work a vow and a mission, fulfilling her life's work until the end.
That's why I'm also praying for his guidance. But definitely, I've always led a mission-driven life. Where God leads me, I'll be there, I'll follow.
I have never been timid about pursuing a mission to help our OFWs. Parang panata ko na yun sa buhay. So whether or not I accept it, the mission and the fight continues.
Willard Cheng, ABS-CBN News.
Philippine poll body urged to conduct a special election to fill the congressional seat of expelled lawmaker Arnulfo Davis Jr. The House of Representatives adopted a resolution stating the COMELEC must call for a special election within 60 to 90 days following the vacancy. Davis was expelled from Congress last week in a historic first for the chamber. House lawmakers cited his disorderly behavior, continued absences, and his failed political asylum bid in Timor-Leste for his expulsion. He has also been designated by government as a terrorist for his alleged role in the murder of Negros Oriental Governor Ruel Degamo and other killings in the province. Philippine senators cite two policemen in contempt during a probe on the death of a Navota City teenager at the hands of police. The two police officers involved in the killing of 17-year-old Jembue Baltazar earned the ire of senators after refusing to properly answer questions. Baltazar was shot dead by police earlier this month in a case of mistaken identity.
Wala po kaming nakitang tumalon. Ang nakita lang po namin nag-iisang tao doon ay si Sunny Boy.
Nakita mo nasa tubig na?
Wala po kami nakitang nasa tubig po.
So paano nagpunta sa tubig si Jimboy, si Sunny Boy nang pinakita niyo? Tapos sabi mo, kamukha ni Jimboy, si Sunny Boy, si Jimboy na suspect nyo. Nakakalito ka. Sabi mo, hindi nakita si Jimboy, si Sunny Boy lang. Tapos sabi mo, si Jimboy at saka yung suspect nyo, si Bonibar ng kamukha. Ano ba tayo na kuya?
Police officers involved in the killing of Baltazar have been relieved from their posts, but they are not yet dismissed from service. 15 jail officials relieved and facing negligence of duty charges over the escape of inmate Michael Cataroja from the National Penitentiary. Cataroja faced a Senate inquiry Thursday nearly a week after he was recaptured. He explained to a Senate panel that boredom drove him to plan his jailbreak. Philippine Prisons Chief Gregorio Katapang says all policies of the new Bibibid prison will be reviewed to ensure that no other inmate can escape.
Lahat po ng policy, i-review, pati pagkuha ng basura, kung anong oras, at dapat siguro wala ng mga pahinati katulad ng PDL na nakikitulong paglipat ng mga ano. And then of course, tama po kayo na kailangan yung nangungulekta ng basura, yung tao lang nila. Wala pong lalapit na PDL kasi baka makahuga na naman.
The Philippine Budget Department has presented to President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. its proposed amendments to the Government Procurement Reform Act. Marcos was reportedly particularly supportive of simplifying the procurement eligibility process and creating an e-marketplace for government agencies. The DBM has been pushing for reforms to the Procurement Act to address underspending, which is seen as one of the main contributors to the slower GDP growth in the second quarter.
Our president po agreed on our amendments. Nag-local government unit po siya, so naintindihan po niya yung proseso ng procurement. So he was able to explain po anong mga areas nahihirapan yung mga katulad po ng mga LGUs at saka yung mga tao sa gobyerno when they procure.
The Philippine Central Bank retains the ceilings on local credit card transactions. The BSP says the maximum interest rate will remain at 3% per month or 36% per year. It also kept unchanged the monthly add-on rates that credit card users can charge on installment loans at a maximum of 1%. Credit card receivables in the Philippines saw a 29% growth as of end May, higher from the 17% a year ago. BSP Governor Eli Ramolona says the Monetary Board sought to strike a balance in providing consumers with access to credit card financing, all while ensuring long-term viability of credit card users.